Thousands of farms were taken over during the Robert Mugabe era, mostly from white farmers, and redistributed to black farmers. The July reparation deal is for property taken on the land, not the land itself, and amounts to $3.5 billion. Even though Zimbabwe does not have the funds, the Zimbabwe Commercial Farmers Union is hopeful.
Given that the average age of farmers when they lost their properties was about 55 and it's nearly 20 years on, you can see that many are no longer able to work, and so they've exhausted their resources. So there will be a relief to them that there's finally possibility of closure.
The union represented 4,500 white farmers forced off their land during reforms that were meant to correct colonial-era land issues. But when the land was redistributed, farm production plunged, sending Zimbabwe's economy into a tailspin from which it has never recovered. Critics say the $3.5 billion deal, which took years to negotiate, will only increase the country's debt.
So it's not just a question of, oh, do we fit into the global capital narrative or the neoliberal free markets, global economic framework, and re-engage private capital that way, which is what government essentially is saying to the world, that it respects private property and may not have that much of an interest anymore in social and economic justice.
Zimbabwe hopes the deal will bring back foreign investment that fled the country when the properties were seized.
You can't at least say that the issue of dealing with the farmers, which has been outstanding for 20 years, shows that we have no priorities. Actually, it is one of the priorities. It's very important that the issue should be resolved. It's also an issue in a sense that triggered the kind of negative sentiments that we've seen from some of the global partners. That needs to be resolved. It's not a normal situation.
Zimbabwe plans to raise the compensation for white farmers through international donors and a long-term bond with the aim of completing payouts in 5 years. Finance Minister Mutuli Ncube says if they can't raise the reparation money in time, the government will simply reschedule payments. The question is, if that happens, will foreign investors feel confident enough in Zimbabwe's government to come back? Columbus Mavhunga for VOA News, Harare.